history a little bit of how, yeah, where it came from.
We got our start with adaptive fitting probably in about 2007, 2008. I was actually just trying to help out that one player, a wheelchair golfer, swings the club one-handed, needed some real help with the grip, and was talking about using Velcro, and he was just a super cool guy, and I wanted to help him out, and it's a good engineering challenge to, how do I help get this guy swinging, you know, how do I take pin clubs and adapt them to his swing, help him play his best? It was just kind of as simple as that, and then I started to go down a rabbit trail of, well, how can we do a better job for anyone who has a sliding restricted swing or different needs? How do we adapt the club to them and be able to service everyone? Like our ping fitting system, I think, does a great job for 99.5% of golfers. And I was trying to build a few extra tools to add on to that to reach the 100% of golfers and really make it something where we can build a club for anyone who wants to play good golf. That's still, I think, where we are today. Is I see it as just an extension to the regular ping fitting system. Whoever you are coming for a fitting and you're trying to get the clubs that work best in your swing, this is just a few extra tools that do things like Velcro grips or oversized grips or longer clubs or extreme upright and flat clubs. It's really just taking a fitting and kind of boosting it, I guess.
And those different tools, we provide those to our accounts. What does that look like?
We have an adaptive fitting pack. It's kind of an add-on to, so if somebody has our fitting tools looking, it sends extra things. It's a little pack that we'll send to certain accounts that if we think, you know, they could get good benefit out of it and use the, like, longer clubs, shorter clubs, more streamlined clubs, some of the special clubs that we do. So it's just an add-on pack to the existing thing that we use.
Well, I'm going to scoot you 1 inch down it. There, down there. Thank you.
Thought I was on the
ball. You were on the ball.
Okay, so let's talk a little bit about kind of how we have, and I'm not sure what the term is down here, but I'm calling it a knowledge database, and I think maybe you use something different. But how do we leverage that in kind of building this type of equipment or tools?
We have a big knowledge-based approach to everything we do. We have our philosophy is to build our knowledge base, and from there, if we know everything we possibly know about the golfer and the engineer, then we can solve any problem. We take the same approach with our adaptive fitting. We've built that knowledge base over now 10 to 15 years of experience and trial and error. I've had plenty of fun experiences of trying something and it's worked terribly, and so I try the exact opposite and now it works, and now we add that to our knowledge base and say, hey, that's a solution that works. And so that knowledge kind of system really helps you build up over a number of years that we have things we've tried that we know work that we can help with.
So how cool is it for you to have this and our engineering team to now have our guests, Jason, Gianna, Andreas, here, kind of visiting Ping, and how special is that?
It's really cool for me to see Jason and Gianna and Andreas all here and all playing Ping clubs and doing great with them. I'm looking forward to seeing the tournament. I think having a really good, well-organized tournament where people can compete and strive to be as good as they possibly can is super important for the game, whether you're talking PGA Tour or, you know, your local Wednesday match with friends. So it's really cool for me. I build up relationships with all these people over the years. It's great to see them improving their game, and if we can be a little bit part of that and helping them with the best possible equipment, hopefully see one of them win the tournament this week, then it's just really cool.
Okay, and let's talk a little bit about kind of our partnership with the USDGA. And Jason talked a little bit about that, but on your side of things, how did that kind of partnership come about?
Yeah, Jason and I have at least come across each other for a few years. You know, we were just talking a little while ago about how we both visited a similar tournament that they have in Europe. They've been running a really nice adaptive golf tournament in Europe for a number of years. And Jason's kind of applying that approach to having an international tournament that's hosted in America every year for a wide range of golfers, which I think is super exciting. So I wanted for us to be a part of that in some way and to be able to be here and be supporting and be helping as many of these golfers try our clubs and see what we can do to help them play their best is, I think it's just a really good fit for my passion and Jason's passion, and it's been a great partnership so far.
Yeah, it does.
That's what happens when it hits 100.
You play through it.
I guess one more thing, and I want to talk a little bit more specifically to Andres' equipment, because it was a more expensive project. Can you just kind of explain that from your side?
Yeah, Andres' equipment in particular is very bespoke. It's the injection molded plastic paddle that we have, and a super long shaft. It is, I can only say, a cool engineering project to work on. Ed and Andreas is awesome, and it's getting the most out of his clubs, and it's super cool to see. But as a straight up golf engineering nerd, it was great to be set a challenge like that. How do we optimize Andreas' equipment? It looks very different to most of our other clubs. We've had a couple of engineers really get their creative juices going on it and doing what engineers love to do, which is solving problems and seeing the result at the end of it. So just a super cool project to work on something like that. And I know all the guys that have had a hand in those want to come out to the tournament and see Andreas use it, because that's ultimately what it's all about. Is you do this engineering, you make something super cool, and it has to work. So actually seeing how it does on the courses.